Hello and welcome to the third part of the How to Create a Modern Home in uMake tutorial series. My name is Nico, and in this part of the series, we are going to take these shapes that we've created and kind of make them look more like a home. So as you can see, what we did is we created these various shapes to kind of start bringing these building blocks and create a home. And what we want to do is add some details to these and make it look more like an actual house. So what I'm going to do to start off is I'm going to bring all these together. Now, I started with them separate so that they're a little bit easier to select and work with and move around. That way you're not accidentally selecting curves or edges that you don't need. But now that we have them kind of placed and shaped the way we want, we're going to kind of assemble them. So to start off, I'm going to move this cube down. So just use the lasso tool and select the whole shape like that. Now I might have selected something. Yeah, I don't need to select that. So, and I don't need this curve. So just kind of make sure that you get just what you need. And now I'm going to move this down, shape down like that. That looks about right. And then I'm going to move this rectangle down. Now you can see I have this gap here going to this shape, and I don't really want this gap here on this one at least. So I'm going to select this edge here, just move this over. There we go. And I'll bring this shape down. Now you can see here we do have the gap, and we can decide what we want to do here. I think what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to shorten this. I'm going to make this gap a little larger, just a tad bit. Something like that. Let's see. Yeah, maybe a little larger. And the reason for this is now there's kind of, if from the top, there's like a wraparound balcony. And so we can actually come over here. I think I'll just make, let's see, I'll select I'll make it easy. I'll just use the push and pull feature. I'll tap once on this surface and I'll just pull this surface out a little bit. And so now we have, that comes out. Now we have a kind of a wraparound balcony, which I think is kind of a cool feature. So the person can walk around like that if they want. All right, so now those elements are assembled. It's starting to look pretty neat. And what we want to do from here is start adding some more details like windows and doors and things like that. So let's jump right into that. So down below here, I kind of want this to be like a big, huge opening. I think I'm gonna have like a pool going into it a little bit. So I'm just gonna draw the best of my ability a rectangle. Hopefully this takes, there we go. And I'm gonna just move this. Now if you tap once on that, you can do the push-pull. If you double tap, then you can actually move that surface. So I'm gonna move this down like that. Let's go back like that. There we go. And I wanna actually move this up over 40, I'll make it 45. There we go. And let's move this down just a little bit more. There we go. And I want to do another one. I think I'm going to have like an entryway over here. Move this down as well. And Make this like 9 feet, 10 feet, there we go. And I'll have one more. So we got that done. Up here, I want to make this have its own balcony and kind of inset look to it. So I'm going to select the edges here. The way I'm going to do this was one is instead of drawing a rectangle, I'm just going to tap copy, and then I'm going to scale these four lines in like that, and that'll create its own. And I'll turn copy off, and since everything is selected, go back to the front view, and I'm just going to move this down and move this part up. That looks good. And now we have that surface there. And I'm going to use a push-pull function here, and I'm going to pull this in quite a bit. Probably something like that. And could even go a little bit more. There we go. So now you have that nice kind of inset look to it. I'll tap good there. And I'm actually going to select this edge, just this edge. Double tap on it, and I'm going to extrude this up just a little bit. Go back here and extrude it up. Let's see, how big is a person? So maybe right around there. There we go. So now we have a kind of a balcony railing or something like that. Okay. And so we're going to continue doing this and adding details in the next section of this, and start adding some color and make this look even more like a home. So what we did in this one is we just kind of assembled these building blocks and started adding some details to them by drawing on the various surfaces and using the push and pull function. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback for us, definitely let us know in the comment section down below, or you can reach out to us on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. We really love to hear your feedback. With that said, stay tuned for the next one. Take care, guys.